Hi everyone, my name is Alex from Toronto Public Library. Welcome to Mini Makers at Home. Mini Makers at Home is an online library program where each week kids and families will explore STEM concepts through fun, hands-on activities. STEM is short for science, technology, engineering, and math. Learning about STEM is really important because these concepts are all around us and helps us discover, explore, and innovate. It's never too early to start having fun with science, technology, engineering, and math. For today's challenge, we will be looking at different types of forces and energy. One type of force we will be exploring today is gravity. So let's talk about it. If I drop a toy or any object, what do you think happens to it? Let's see. But why would it fall to the ground instead of floating off into space? Well, it drops to the ground because of gravity. Gravity is what pulls everything towards the ground. Think about what happens to astronauts in space. Astronauts float because there is no gravity. Without the force of gravity, air, water, animals, everything would fly off into space. Gravity is an invisible force that pulls everything towards the Earth. It's what keeps you on the ground and what makes things fall. Another type of force we will be exploring today is friction. It is a force between two surfaces that causes a moving object to slow down, like a brake on a bicycle. When you want to stop your bicycle, you press the brake and your bicycle slows down because of the friction between the brakes and the wheels. The amount of friction changes depending on the type of surface. Rougher surfaces increase friction. For instance, if you push a toy car on a rough surface, like a carpet, it increases friction, causing it to move slower, like this. While smoother surfaces allow objects to slide more easily. If you push a toy car on a smooth surface, like a tabletop or solid floor, it moves faster because there is less friction, like this. Today's STEM challenge also explores two types of energy. Potential energy is one of the two main types of energy. Potential energy is the stored energy an object has because of its position. It is also the energy that an object has when it is not in motion. For example, tree branches high up in a tree have potential energy because they can fall to the ground. The second main type of energy is called kinetic energy, which is the energy of moving things, such as a soccer ball when it's kicked, a flying airplane, a moving car, or bicycle. The heavier an object is, the faster it will move and the more kinetic energy it will have. If an object rolls down a hill, it will pick up speed as it travels and increase its kinetic energy, like this. For this week, we are going to build a racetrack for a small car, and you will see the force of gravity and motion of energy in action. When designing your racetrack, remember that you probably need to make many adjustments before it works the way you want it to. But that's okay. Scientists often have to experiment with something many times before it works. It's how we learn. So let's get started. For this activity, you will need a poster board or cardboard box, construction paper or toilet paper rolls at home, masking tape or green painter's tape, a pair of scissors, a small ball, or a toy car. Using these materials, we will build a vertical racetrack with a slight bend. We will begin by rolling construction paper into tubes and securing it with tape. I had pre-cut the tape already to make it easier. To make shorter tubes, we will cut construction paper in half before rolling it into a tube. Remember to ask an adult for help when using scissors. You can also use paper towel or toilet paper rolls instead. Make sure that the tube is wide enough for a toy car or small ball to drop through it. After we have the tubes all rolled up, we can start assembling the racetrack by taping the paper tubes or on the poster board or cardboard box. Then we can tape the second tube next to the first one and so on, just like this. There is no right way to do this. You will need to experiment with placing the tubes at different angles and distances before it works. Try to guess which angle and distance will work to carry the toy car through the track. Now we can hold and release the toy car through the first tube and watch it run down the track. What did you notice? Does the track work better when the tubes are farther apart or closer together? Does it make it all the way to the end? If it did not make it to the end, it's okay. Try adjusting the angles of the tubes or improve the tube connections. And keep on trying. You're almost there. If it did make it to the end, good job. Now here's another challenge. Try to build onto the racetrack by connecting more tubes. Can you add more bends to the track to keep any of the objects in motion longer? Think about what angles of the tubes make the car go faster. Just remember to stop and test the racetrack after completing each new segment. You can also try launching a cotton ball down the racetrack. Does it fall at the same speed as the small ball or toy car? Well, give it a try to find out. Parents and caregivers, you play an important role in supporting your child's learning by participating and engaging with them in everyday activities. I hope you enjoyed today's Mini Makers at Home program. Check back soon for more Toronto Public Library Mini Makers at Home programs. Bye for now.